In this video, we're going to talk about the dark side of the industry. The scammers, the fakers, and the people who make it impossible for you to make money in this business. Hello and welcome to the Pine Street Capital YouTube channel, where we talk all things trading and investing. My name is Ron and I'm the managing partner of Pine Street Capital, and I've been trading for over 6 years. Today, we are going to be talking about the dark side of the industry. If you already haven't watched parts 1 and 2 of the Introduction to Trading mini course, I'll link them up here so that you can go and watch those. That way you come into this one with a lot more context. Now, if you remember where I ended it on the previous one, I did point out that you can actually make money within this business as long as you stay away from the dark side. And that's what we're going to be talking about within this presentation.
In this lesson, we're going to cover the dark side of trading. And by the end of it, you should understand the negative effects of trading. You should learn about the most common scams and unethical business practices within this industry, and you should know what you can do to avoid them. We're going to start with the negative effects of trading, and you might not realize it right now whilst you're just starting out, or if you've been at this for a couple of months, maybe even a couple of years, but this is going to be news to a lot of people. Some of them are very shocking. Some of them may put you off, but it's just the reality of it, and you really need to know what you're getting yourself into. And you need to put yourself in a position whereby you can avoid the negative backlash that you might get as a result of trading. So the first negative effect of trading is wealth destruction. There's so many people out there who have lost unreasonable amounts of money in this industry as a result of trading losses and getting scammed. There are people almost every day who lose at least $1 million because of these scammers. If you've been around for a bit longer, you'll be familiar with the story of Bernie Madoff, who ran off with $65 billion of investor money. Although scams are huge in this industry, they're not as common as people just losing money because they have no idea what they're doing. Sometimes what happens in such situations is that people end up claiming that the broker scammed them and that the entire industry is a scam. And that's just the reality of it. People deposit money into their trading accounts and gamble it away up to a point where they're left with nothing, and then say they've been scammed. The truth is, trading is definitely one way in which you can destroy your wealth very quickly, no matter how much or how little you have. One thing I always say is that there are very few places in the world where a fool and his money are separated faster than it happens in the financial markets. And that's just the fact of it. The other negative effect that trading can have is it's a very good way in which you can develop and feed a gambling addiction. When you don't know what you're doing, the financial markets are one place you can really feed a gambling addiction because of the fact that there are a lot of emotions that you go through when you're trading, and a lot of them are the same emotions that you go through when you're gambling. The intensity of the emotions are the real indicator as to whether or not you actually are gambling, and gambling with a negative expected value. This is one thing you really want to avoid because it usually doesn't end well. One thing I will tell you is that when you're in the financial markets and your trading process looks very similar to the same way that you'd bet on a football game, then you're doing it wrong. An example could be, well, you place a bet on a football game and you place a bet on Chelsea beating Manchester United. You're sitting there hoping that the team that you put your money on will win. That's when you know you're gambling, and you go through certain emotions when you do that. If you're trading and you're sitting there hoping that the market will go in your direction, then you're not trading, you're gambling. This is one of the biggest concepts that a lot of people don't understand, and you might not understand it now if you've been trading for a few months or if you're just starting out. It's a concept that you'll only really understand once you've mastered the skill of trading. Moving on to the third point, the next negative effect that trading has is a deterioration in your mental health. When you trade, you go through a lot of emotional swings. When you take the approach of the typical retail trader, these emotional swings are amplified times 10. When the market plays with your emotions like a yo-yo with the ups and downs, this may have a really damaging effect on your mental health as you go through periods of depression and excessive losses. I mean, if you Google some of the horror stories from the global financial crisis, you hear of people on Wall Street who jumped out of buildings because of excessive losses that they couldn't afford. And this is not the position that you really want to put yourself into when you're trading the financial markets. The next negative effect, which is closely linked to deterioration in your mental health is a deterioration in your personal relationships. Because emotions run high when you're trading, your personal relationships can start to affect your trading performance, and your trading performance can start to affect your personal relationships. An example could be you going to the trading desk right after you've had a fight with your wife. So you make an irrational decision in the markets and take an insane amount of risk on the trade, which ends up losing money. So you go back home and start blaming her for the money that you've lost in the markets. Sometimes you could be in a bad mood because you lost money in the markets, so you're not in the mood to talk to anyone. And over time, your relationships with friends and family deteriorate because you can't enjoy quality time with them. The other way that trading gets in the way of your personal relationships is because of the fact that you've gotten into something that very few people understand or are interested in. You don't have many people to talk to about what you're going through in trading. It's literally just you in front of the screens 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, which can really start to take its toll on you. Now, let's get into how you avoid the negative effects of trading. The first way is to invest wisely. Don't invest more money than you're willing to lose, and don't invest until you've gotten the proper education. The second is to keep a good network of people around you. The third, and what is probably the most important, is to have realistic expectations. And the last one is you need to stay away from scammers and parties that engage in unethical business practices, because it's probably one of the more painful ways of losing money. Now, let's go into each of these in more detail. The first is invest wisely. I wish this one went without saying, but a lot of people still do it. If you need to use the money on rent, food, tuition, or any other necessities, do not, I repeat, do not touch it. It doesn't count as part of your investable assets. Second one, do not take out a loan or use a credit card to deposit into your trading account. Now, what you'll find is on the brokerage side, you might be encouraged to do such things. And if they do encourage you to do that, more likely than not, the broker is probably unregulated, in which case you should probably stay away and look for a different broker. But the next thing is, scared money is dead money. Never ever forget this. If you're ever scared of losing a trade or losing the money in your account, then you're more likely than not to lose it, because it will lead to emotional decisions that you otherwise wouldn't have made if you were trading with what we call risk capital. That's money that you're willing to put at risk, as in, if you were to lose the money, you wouldn't go into a state of depression tomorrow, or you wouldn't be too upset about it, you know. So just remember, scared money is dead money. Now, the next point is, do not deposit into your trading account until you've received the proper education. If you deposit into your trading account and start trading and expect to make money, then hey, you're relying on nothing more than luck to make you money. And it's no different from the approach that someone who walks into a casino is doing. Except in a casino, you might actually stand better chances. So if you deposit money into your trading account and you know nothing more than a few technical analysis indicators, support and resistance, and you don't really understand what drives the market, what your edge is, what your trading strategy is, you're just gambling, really. Some people might justify this by saying, oh no, I've learned a few of the trading concepts off YouTube and I really think I can make money in the markets. My question is, if you were learning to fly a plane, would you learn to fly a plane off YouTube? The fact of the matter is, you probably wouldn't choose to learn how to fly a plane off YouTube, because these are two highly specialized skills that you really need the proper education in order to acquire the skill at the end of the day. And if you don't, that's completely up to you. The next point is, you need to keep a good network. The people you keep around you should support you, encourage you, and motivate you. If you've ever heard the saying, you are an average of the five people you associate yourself with the most, and you've never tested it out, try it out right now. Look at your WhatsApp chats or your Messenger chats and see who the last five people you would say you interact with a lot. And what you'll find is that you share very similar character traits with them, along with habits, actually. If those people drink a lot of alcohol, you probably drink a lot of alcohol too. If those people make a lot of money, you probably make a lot of money too. I mean, birds of the same feather flock together at the end of the day. And you better choose your flock wisely. The next point is, you need friends who are traders and you need friends who are not traders. But those people still need to have the same kind of ambition that you do, the same drive that you do. These people will pick you up when you're down because they know what it's like to be down when you have such high expectations of yourself. And they'll also be able to relate with you in such a way that other people might not necessarily understand. I mean, if you surround yourself with people who don't have the same ambitions, who are not going to say things like, I'm going to get that Lamborghini in the next 5-10 years, you know, those people will laugh at you when you say such things, because it's so unrealistic to them, and they sort of impose their own beliefs about their abilities on you, and you don't want that kind of thing around you. Now, the reason you want friends who are traders and friends who aren't traders is because friends who are traders can relate to what you're going through in the market, and these are people who will be able to give you the proper advice rather than seeking out advice from someone who doesn't necessarily understand trading at that level. Now, the reason you'd like friends who aren't traders is because you don't want your entire life to revolve around trading. You want to have some kind of a social aspect to it. You don't want to be out on, say, a Saturday night at a bar and you're talking about what Euro USD did or talking about the non-farm payroll number. So that's the reason you want to structure your social life that way. The next question someone might have after going through all these points is, does this mean you should get rid of the ones who don't support, encourage, and motivate you? Not necessarily. It just means you should limit the interaction that you have with them, so much so that it doesn't influence your beliefs and your unsystematic side to your brain at the end of the day. So with such people, what you can do is you can talk to them at times when they're most positive, as in people who don't support, encourage, and motivate you aren't necessarily bad people. You know, they can have negative effects on you, yes. But at the end of the day, if they're people who have your best interest at heart, there might come a time when there's a real conflict of interest. And their interest in protecting you might then hold you back from what you're really trying to achieve. Moving on to realistic expectations, the first thing I have to say about this is fantasy returns do not exist. If someone tells you that they make an average of 50% per month trading, they're probably lying to you. And you can simply prove this by asking them two questions. You need to ask them if they've been trading consistently for the past 3 years. If their answer is yes, then you ask them why they're not on the Forbes list. Because if they've been trading consistently for the past 3 years, right, and they started with, say, a small amount, I mean, before they were trading consistently, they might have made a little bit of money along their path to profitability. So they might have had, say, £2,000 to start with. So if they started trading with £2,000 3 years ago and they make an average return of 50% per month, that would mean that they currently have $4.368 billion in their trading account right now. You can see the exact figure right there. And that's simply the compounded return of 50% per month for 3 years. So if you start with $2,000 today and you make a 50% return on average, you have $4 billion in your trading account. The simple fact is that if they're not on the Forbes list, they're lying to you. Here's the math behind the $4 billion that I got. You simply multiply $2,000 by 1.5, which is the 50% return, times 36 months, and you get $2,000 times 2.1 million, and that equals $4 billion. I won't even get started on the guys who say earn 100% daily or 50% monthly, because all those guys are trillionaires and quintillionaires and quadrillionaires and infinitiers, and we're just too poor for them. As for scams and unethical business practices, I could go on and on about this forever, but what I want to do today is educate you on some of the most common ones that you need to avoid. Now, there might be some that I don't cover within this, but there are some that will still surprise me today. But anyway, the most common one is the account management scam. What will usually happen is someone will approach you on social media or personally, and they'll tell you, hey, I'm a really good trader. I generate thousands of percent every year trading, and I can manage your account for you. What usually ends up happening is this person takes your money and you never see them again. Or if they actually do trade it, what's more likely than not to happen is they actually end up losing all your money. And sometimes they'll be upfront about that. Sometimes they'll send you fictitious statements about how your account is growing, and they'll try to solicit even more deposits out of you. Now, the first question you should ask someone who offers you this, not that you should be interested in the first place, but ask them if they're regulated to do so. More likely than not, they'll walk you around in circles with long explanations about their profit, and just ask them direct questions. If they don't give you a straight answer, then I'd be skeptical. If they do claim that they are regulated, because some of them are crazy enough to actually do that, what you then do is you ask them for their regulation number or which body they're registered with. And it's all a matter of a quick Google search, and you'll find the answer as to whether or not they're regulated. If they are regulated, you can invest with them, but do so cautiously. If they're not, then stay away. In fact, run. The next common scam that I usually see is multi-level marketing. Now, what they usually do is they send you a WhatsApp message or an Instagram DM or even a Facebook Messenger message. Sometimes they even post on Facebook. And how you can usually tell is they're usually very long messages with emojis, a lot of emojis, so that they can keep your attention for a longer period of time. And they put a lot of emphasis on the amount of money that you can make daily or weekly or monthly. But they include very little detail on what the actual product is or what the source of income is. If you're presented with one of these opportunities, stay away. And what you usually find is they usually spam forex trading channels or places with large audiences with these things. Sometimes they'll even tell you that this company is reputable because it's a registered company, and that doesn't really mean anything because anyone can register a company. And what people usually mistake that company registration for is regulation. But what I will tell you is most of them are not regulated by a financial regulatory authority. What will happen is they'll ask you to pay, say, $100. And if you bring in three people or 10 people who pay $100, and those people bring in people, and it just goes, the pyramid goes on. So they try and recruit as many people paying $100. So essentially, the money that you get, if you do get money, comes from the people who would have paid this company as well. And from the money that those guys bring in, they bring in more people, bring in more money. The company basically takes a little piece of that, or they might take a huge chunk of that, and then pay you until they can't pay you anymore. That's if they do pay you at all. What you'll find is some of these ones that are just starting out will actually just take your money and run. So I'd stay away from these altogether, whether they pay out or not, because at the end of the day, you're harming the person directly below you. And more times than not, these are people that you know. And what you're basically doing is you're helping this company take money out of the pocket of someone you know, and you're taking money out of the other pocket at the same time. So definitely stay away from this kind of thing. It is illegal, and you can really get in trouble for it. A lot of these guys also then use the whole hype behind Bitcoin to sort of justify the reason why they need to take your money for an investment opportunity. And in truth, a lot of this isn't, there's no real underlying Bitcoin investment. Sometimes they'll show you a screenshot of a text message where they received from the bank saying, oh, you've received this much from your investment in that, and that sort of, that's the proof that they need to sort of draw you in. But anyway, the next one is Ponzi schemes. Ponzi schemes are simply whereby someone promises you an investment opportunity. And again, they put a lot of emphasis on the fact that you'll earn this much daily, this much weekly, this much monthly, whatever it is. And the moment they draw you in, they take that money and simply put it in their pockets. Once you ask for a withdrawal, they might give you a withdrawal if they have enough cash on hand. But if they don't have enough cash on hand to satisfy all the withdrawals, then the thing just completely falls apart. The next one is profile jacking, whereby a scammer will essentially create a profile of someone popular, and they'll start selling investments or education or something like that. So they're basically impersonating someone who's got a good reputation, and they leverage the good reputation of that person to then start basically taking people's money. For example, someone could create a Pine Street Capital Instagram page one day and then start telling people that Pine Street Capital has a new course and you can buy it for, say, $1,000. And people will think that it's actually Pine Street Capital, and then they end up paying these guys for the course and they don't get the course, or it's some terrible product. The next one is pump and dumps, where what will happen is someone will convince you to buy a certain stock or cryptocurrency or whatever it is, and you buy it. What they wouldn't have told you before is that they bought it before at a lower price before convincing you to buy it. So they get a whole bunch of people to buy it. And, you know, when a lot of people are buying something, the price goes up and up and up and up and up and up. And eventually, once they see that the price has reached a satisfactory level, what they end up doing is they dump it. So they start selling, and you'll be stuck in whilst they're getting out through all the people they're convincing to buy it. This is a form of market manipulation, and it's illegal in most jurisdictions. But people do it anyway, so don't fall prey to these pump and dumps, because sometimes, as a beginner, they're a lot harder to spot. Next one is fake educators. The easiest way to spot these guys is if you go onto their Instagram page, their Facebook page, or their YouTube channel, and all you see is them showing you a flashy lifestyle. They've got flashy cars. They've got pictures with large wads of cash. What they usually do is they rent these vehicles, they go to Airbnbs, and they buy fake cash on the internet. That's right, you can actually buy fake cash on the internet. And they start showing you this stuff on camera so that you're lured in because of the natural human emotion of greed, and you want what they have. So they then tell you, I made all this money trading Forex, and you can do it too, because I've got this educational program that you can buy for $1,000. Now, those are the fake educators for you. Most of the time, these people would have never placed a trade in their lives. They don't know what trading is. And within the curriculum of their courses, they'll usually have things like technical analysis, support and resistance. They'll show you some very basic stuff that you can find anywhere on the internet, and that doesn't work anyway. I mean, they don't show you the real stuff that you need in order to make money in trading. One shocking thing that I found amongst these fake educator courses or fake gurus, as people are calling them now, is they usually include a lot of technical analysis. And the purpose of this is so that they get you to trade on a brokerage platform as quick as possible, so that you feel like the educational program has gotten you somewhere, when in reality it hasn't. One of the most important concepts within trading is statistics specific to a trading context. And that's what a lot of these guys don't include in their courses, because of the fact that they actually don't know how to trade. The next one is fake brokers. Now, fake brokers, there are too many variations of the scam, but basically if someone gives you a call and asks you to make a deposit into some random bank account, or it tells you to deposit it to some cell phone wallet or a shady website that's not even secure, then more likely than not, you're being scammed by a fake broker who claims that they're regulated. What you usually want to do when you're selecting a broker is you want to, first of all, ensure that this broker actually has registered as a company. Next thing you want to do is you want to check if this broker is regulated, and you're going to have to double check with the regulatory body that they claim they're regulated by to see if they're regulated. Now, some of these brokers will usually have fake regulatory websites set up by themselves in order to convince you that they are regulated, and you need to be wary of this. But to save you all that trouble, we've actually got a list of the brokers that we prefer to trade with. They're also brokers that we trust and provide the best services that you'll find anywhere in the industry. And you can find that list of brokers by clicking on the button below. And the last point is just don't put your money into anything that you don't understand, whereby you don't understand what the source of returns is or how it works. The next thing we're going to cover is unethical business practices. Now, I'm probably going to get a lot of heat from this one, but this is one of the most common areas whereby people practice unethical business, and that is forex signals. I will tell you right now that you are highly unlikely to make money from forex signals or any kind of signals, whether or not the signals given are actually accurate. First of all, because of the fact that you're not going to catch every single signal. Now, the fact that you don't catch every single signal means that you're not following the strategy the way it was meant to be traded in the first place. I mean, if you're missing every signal at a certain point in time because you're at the desk or you're sleeping or whatever it is, then you don't get the same statistics that the person actually trading the signals does. Right now, you may say, okay, I've got an auto trade copier, that's cool, but at the end of the day, the type of people that signals attract are people who are looking for instant gratification. And that's because of the fact that signals themselves are a product that attracts people who are after instant gratification. And the problem with instant gratification within this industry is because of the fact that you're going to get emotional when the results aren't necessarily going your way. So you may decide to skip on a certain signal, or you may decide to double up your position size in the next trade because the signals have lost you money over the past maybe three trades, and then you end up losing that trade, and then it leads to a downward spiral. The point is, signals as a product, the type of person that it attracts, doesn't necessarily have the capability to implement them in the way that they're meant to be implemented. Now, that's before we even get to the fact that a lot of the signal providers out there don't even provide proper signals which they're trading themselves and which produce results. What they'll usually do is they'll flaunt a bit of wealth, show fake results on their website, and someone will be drawn in because they've achieved this result and they've shown me proof that they've achieved this result. What that person doesn't know is the fact that it's very easy to fake a lot of these results, which is what most of the signal providers do and a lot of the fake educators. They fake results, and if I were you, I wouldn't even consider any kind of results that any one of these guys shows me to be credible, because it's so easy to create a fake statement and then start selling a course or providing signals to people based on those fake results. Another common thing that you'll see with signals is they'll market their signals as being 90% accurate or 80% accurate. And what will usually happen is sometimes it may be true that they're 90% accurate, but the problem is when they make money, an example could be when they make money, they make $1. But when they lose money, they lose $100. So they've essentially got a 99% chance of making money and a 1% chance of losing money. But that 1% will come. And when it comes, it's going to wipe out your entire account. So generally, stay away from signal providers who will tell you these signals are 90% accurate or anything like that. Stay away from signal providers altogether, I'd say. The next one you want to stay away from is robots. Now, people will usually sell you a robot for $100 or $200, and they might show you fake results that robot has supposedly generated and how it can make you financially free and you don't have to need to put in any work. All you need to do is plug and play. While the idea of this sounds attractive, and the price point might lead you to believe that these robots are more credible and might actually work if someone charges, say, $100 or $200 as opposed to $20 or something like that. This usually isn't the case, and the testimonials that they have on that page are usually testimonials from people who have used it for 1 or 2 days or a month, which really isn't enough time to determine whether a robot actually does work And people will believe that. But what you really need to understand about a lot of these automated trading systems and trading strategies in general is the fact that there's certain market conditions in which they work. And the moment that market condition doesn't exist, then, hey, it's redundant. The other unethical business practice I've seen is multi-level marketing again. There's a scammy way to do it in which people just pay you money and you start spending it and you're only sort of operating it as a Ponzi scheme. And that's the scammy way. The unethical way of operating it is by delivering the product that people are buying underlying that MLM. But most of the time it will be a product that the people who are buying into it aren't actually interested in. They are interested in the income producing side of it. And again, don't invest in anything where you don't understand the source of returns. The final one is unethical brokers. And I'd say with unethical brokers, a lot of these guys will convince you or coerce you into doing things that you probably shouldn't be doing, like depositing money into your account using a credit card, whereby you might be inclined to deposit more than you can afford. Or they might give you education packages that give you some sort of confidence whereby you think that you really understand how the financial markets work. It's the reason why you'll find a lot of the training that you get from brokers is mostly based on technical analysis, support and resistance. It's usually very basic stuff that the average person can understand, and their incentive in giving you that training is so that you get started trading on the platform as soon as possible and generating the broker revenue. So as for the kind of training that you get from brokers, 9 times out of 10, I'd be skeptical of it. Definitely stay skeptical of the training that your broker will give you, because at the end of the day, they're incentivized to generate as much commission as they can from you through your trading activity. And the sooner you have the confidence to trade, the sooner you'll start making money from the broker. Now, a lot of brokers do provide educational material. Some of it is good, but most of it I'd stay away from completely. And again, if you are looking for an ethical, real broker who's regulated and will provide you with the best services that you possibly can, just click on the link below to see the list of the brokers that we use, trust, and are regulated in jurisdictions with strict financial regulation. We've been in the industry for a while and haven't found better service offerings than the services that were offered by these brokers. Once you've checked those out and opened your account, you can move on to the next lesson where we'll cover how you actually make money in the financial markets.